Hey guys, what's up? How's it going? I hope you're having a great day. My name is Hadit, and today I will go over the recent blog posted on the Heroes of the Storm website by Vaeflare. But before we go on any further, make sure to hit that subscribe button to stay updated with the latest Heroes of the Storm news. Today's blog is titled Heroes of the Storm Preview, Unlocking the Hero Within, and with that intro, their intention with this blog is to shed some light onto their current plans for heroes, skins, mounts, their experience system, and much more. Let's start with heroes in gold. All the heroes available in the game come from all the Blizzard franchises. Whether it's from World of Warcraft, Starcraft, and Diablo, chances are that the important figures will appear in the game. They won't be all available at once though. Each week we will be able to choose between 5 different heroes, and once we reach level 7, a 6th hero slot will appear. These heroes are randomly picked and will be shuffled every Tuesday, so you will be able to eventually try them all out. If you would like to consistently play a hero each week, you will need to purchase it with gold, which is the currency used in the game. You can earn this currency by leveling and completing daily quests. These quests will be available from level 6 and on. Even though there's a hero rotation, you're able to try out the heroes through the Try Me button in-game. This will let you test out the hero abilities and will let you explore and try out the different talents, see if you would like to purchase this hero. You can also obtain Vala the Demon Hunter if you pre-order the Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls game client for no additional cost. Now let's go over to the skins for Heroes of the Storm. Each skill will have 3 different colors available. The standard tint will be available, and then the other 2 are obtained through hero quests. To be specific, the 2nd and 4th hero quests. Just like heroes, mounts will also have 3 available tints, with the first one being available and the other 2 will be obtainable through quests. In addition, Heroes of the Storm Alpha and Beta testers will receive a unique mount for helping them try out the Blizzard store and phases of testing. The next topic of this blog post is about the experiences and progression. As any other game, increasing your level also comes with good perks like earning gold, unlocking heroes, and work on quests which will grant you awards like skins and tints. You will be able to gain levels by earning experience, and you can earn experience through games, in-game achievements, the bonus granted from winning games, and an additional bonus, which is the friend bonus, when you play with Battle.net friends and daily quests. I hope you enjoyed this Heroes of the Storm news video. Are you planning on trying it out? I'm extremely excited about this game and can't wait to create more content for you guys. Don't forget to smash that like button if you enjoyed it. See you guys next time. Going to be entering the initial alpha stages very soon. One of the first stages is called the technical alpha. But what is that exactly? Like any other alpha game stage, the game is far from being ready to be published, but they're finally ready to start letting a few players experience